Okay, there seems to be some interest in these videos where I tear apart ammo and look at what's inside and, weigh the powder and kind of stuff like that. And so today we're going to look at some Finnish 7.62x, I guess it'd be 53 rimmed. That's how they refer to it. This is pre-World War II stuff. We'll look at some of the head stamps here close up. But it's more or less a clone of the old Russian, I think it's L-ball, the Russians called it, like the first Spitzer round they come out with around 1909. The Finns called it, I guess, the S-bullet or S-ball, somewhere around, something like that. But so most of them are like a Cooper Nickel bullet. You see there's quite a crimp on there. And all the ones I have here, they're all VPT marked. This one here is 1933. Primer is sort of a coppery colored on that one. This one here is 1935. So that's probably the kind of stuff they would have been shooting at the Russians in the Winter War and stuff like that. I'm not sure if they replaced this with the D-ball, because they had the heavier bullet. 1937, this one. This one here. 33. Four. And this one's 38. So that's the newest one I got there. I see they're annealed fairly well. Fins put together pretty good ammo. I found a lot of this stuff had corrosion inside of it. I should have noticed this one here is a sort of a copper bullet instead of being the Cooper Nickel like the other ones. I guess they just used what they had at the time, because it's this one's older than some of the other ones that have Cooper Nickel again, so I guess they just sort of whatever was available they used. So this is what the bullet looks like. If anybody that has like that 1940s Russian light ball ammo, it's really similar kind of bullet to that. It has sort of a cone shaped base on it there. That'll focus there now. Sort of a cone base, or kind of, I guess it'll kind of expand out a bit when you fire it. And you can see there's where they crimped into it. I don't know if there was actually a crimping groove there. It's just that it's just a vicious crimp that sort of squeezed that into the bullet, because it just has a, I guess it just has a soft lead core. No iron or anything inside of these. They're 147.5 or something like that. They're 147.9. They're around 148 grains anyway. This scale sort of 47.8. Yeah, it's somewhere around there. So that's. But that bullet, and I measured it, it's around 306 diameter. Which seems kind of small, but a lot of the Finnish guns were, some of their like their M27s and stuff were, had like a 309 or 309.5, somewhere 308 groove diameter. But I think the way these bullets are supposed to work is they're supposed to expand at the base a little bit, so you can get away with. They're more or less kind of like a bore rider, and then they'll expand at the base to seal the grooves in, so you don't get gas blow by. So it kind of, you get good accuracy, but then you can get less pressure. Say you have like a bigger bullet, and then you have a tighter barrel, then you can run into kind of problems like that. So that's the bullet anyway. So it's sort of, old school kind of flat base. It looks a lot like, if anybody's familiar with Turkish military ammo, 8mm. The profile of their bullet is very similar to this, kind of a flat base, but it's kind of like a little cone to it, and it's quite undersized. Like it's like most 8mm are like 323 or 324, 325, somewhere around there. And those bullets usually measure 320, 321, kind of somewhere around there. But I think it's how you get crazy velocities and not outrageous pressures and stuff. I think it's how they get around that kind of stuff. But that's the kind of bullet they had, the Russians, I think, used during the war. But they went away from it and went to the with the iron core and the LPS stuff with the boat tail bullet at about 309 or 310 diameter, somewhere around there. But because down range a boat tail bullet is superior, but I believe this bullet here is superior for, like, if your barrel gets a little bit worn, it'll kind of gonna last longer. Where with boat tail bullets, is if your barrel starts getting worn, then your accuracy starts to suffer. But as after the war, the 7.6-54 for the Russians more or less became a machine gun round, so I suppose you could just get new barrels, or we had to worry about that kind of stuff. So we'll weigh the powder here and take a look at it. Zero that. It's all out of there. There's a little bit of corrosion in this one, if you can see it in there. Some are much worse. So it's got moisture. So it says 48 grains of, like, an unknown sort of... it looks a lot like German-type smokeless. Sort of like a sliced up... Sort of like a flake powder, but it's... I guess they roll powder and then sort of slice it up in these little squares. And then it's got like a... Got like a graphite kind of coating on it. So it's actually... kind of looks like flake powder, so you think it'd be kind of like fast burning, but it's not... It's sort of... I don't know. It's not super fast, but it's a really good powder, actually. But that kind of makes sense. I think the Finns were more close to the... closer to the Germans than they were to the Russians, so they'd probably be borrowing or buying German style powder or German style or German powder technology or whatever. If they wanted to do their own kind of thing, they could, because the Turks did the same. They use this style of powder. Quite a few European countries use German style powder, like the Austrians, Lincoln, their 8x56, the Portuguese 8mm you bump into has this kind of powder in it, and it's a Turkish, as I mentioned. So and it, it's kind of turned off, but it said 48 grains, so that's actually quite a lot for a that's comparable to, like, I don't know, like a slower stick powder, like 4350 or something. You have quite a lot of powder, and a long barrel, like out of a M39 or an M91 or something, you get some pretty vicious velocities. I should probably crony a couple of these. This is all that I get left for this ammo, because I had about, I don't know, I had 20 rounds at one time, but a lot of them were, quite a few of them were duds, and then some of them were, all rotted to hell, and they're all different years, but should maybe pop a couple off and see what the velocity is. But I think it's somewhere in the 2800, close to 2900 feet per second range in a long barrel. So I don't think that website there has this ammo listed for their velocities and stuff. So anyway, that's enough talking about this, almost 9 minutes of blabbing on about this ammo, but hope you find it interesting, and talk to you later.